Next, we introduce an integration technique called the inverse substitution. Previously, we learned how to turn the chain rule for differentiation to an integration technique called substitution, in which we introduced a new variable, let's say t, to be equal to some function of x. To complete the substitution, we have to find the differential of t and replace every occurrence of x in the original integrand with some expression in terms of t. So to have nothing but some function of t left in the integrand. Turns out that it is possible to reverse the process and introduce a new variable, let's say t, by setting x to be equal to some function of t. In such a case, we have to find the differential of x and replace every occurrence of x in the original integrand with some expression in terms of t, so to have nothing but some function of t left in the integrand. Due to the nature of the relationship between the two processes, we will refer to the original substitution technique as the direct substitution and the new substitution technique as the inverse substitution. Let's review the following example of a direct substitution. We first recognize the pattern and rearrange the integrand. Then, set up the substitution by setting a new variable, let's say t, equal to the natural logarithm of x, and finding the differential of t. Next, we plug everything into the original integral, and now we have nothing but the function of t left in the integrand. We finish the process by finding the antiderivative and plugging the natural logarithm of x back for t. Now, let's see how a reverse substitution can be used to do the same problem. We set up the substitution by replacing the original variable x with the natural exponential function of t, and finding the differential of x in terms of t. Next, we plug everything into the original integral, and notice how, after simplifying, we have nothing but a function of t left in the integrand. We finish the process by finding the antiderivative and replacing t with the natural logarithmic function. Notice that we got the same exact answer as in the previous example. We discussed and practiced an integration technique called the inverse substitution that works for the same reason as the direct substitution, but in reverse.